The SCADAPAC 470XI remote smart RTU and controller with integrated edge platform is the latest model in the SCADAPAC X70 series, combining wide-ranging RTU capabilities with the flexibility of Linux. In this video, we will give a general overview of using Docker on your SCADAPAC. For those unfamiliar with the technology, Docker is a common type of container used on embedded Linux, which works similarly to a virtual machine. A container is a software solution that packages up code and all its dependencies, such that the application or applications, when deployed in a container, can run quickly and reliably. The difference between containers and VMs, or virtual machines, is that containers are smaller and lighter, but are also more reliant on the host system. The ability to run Docker containers brings access to a nearly endless variety of embedded Linux packages and libraries to the SCADAPAC. The SCADAPAC has two halves, the RTU half with the real-time operating system, and the edge half with Linux. In order to use Docker on your SCADAPAC, you will have to configure one of the Ethernet ports of your SCADAPAC's edge board to have an IP address on your router's subnet, but outside your router's DHCP range. In this case, we'll use Ethernet 3. You then configure the SCADAPAC's gateway to point to your router's IP address. This means that if your router is at 192.168.8.1, that's what you put as your SCADAPAC's gateway. After clicking Apply for the network settings and going online, click Right to push these network settings to your SCADAPAC. On the SCADAPAC, we can ping the IP address of the Google DNS server at 8.8.8.8, but if we try to ping www.google.com by typing its domain name, we can't. This is because DNS is not set up in my SCADAPAC. The DNS server can be configured from the SCADAPAC's command line. On Linux systems, the resolve.conf file contains a list of the IP addresses of DNS servers that can be used for domain name lookups. We can modify this from the command line. Copy the commands from step 3 to delete the contents of the resolve.conf and replace with Google's DNS servers. Now we are able to successfully ping www.google.com. In order to use Docker, we think it's a good idea to have a reference or cheat sheet, such as those found online or in Appendix A of the SCADAPAC 47XI application note Docker container with Ubuntu for Python solutions. The first thing we want to do is see what containers are already on the SCADAPAC. We'll type clear and hit enter. Then type Docker container ls to see all running containers. We can see there are no running containers. Now we'll type Docker container ls hyphen a to see both the running and stopped containers. We can see that we have a container named Ubuntu that we want to delete. Now we'll copy an example Docker run command from Appendix A to the SSH terminal, then we'll hit enter. Since I've already done this before and the image is cached, the command executes instantly. If this had been my first time running the command, it would have taken a couple minutes. A blank Ubuntu container like this one is about 50 megabytes. You will see the command prompt no longer says SCADAPAC, but is instead showing the container's command prompt. From the Docker website, you will see it documented that Docker run creates and then starts containers. Before being able to install any program inside an Ubuntu container, you must first run apt-get update. This causes the container to retrieve the list of available packages from the Ubuntu repositories. This will be the name of the newly created container. The name is used in commands such as to start, stop, check the status, or delete the container. You will remember when we created the container that we used the hyphen v argument to map /home/root/Ubuntu on the host to /data in the container. In order for the container's contents to be persistent, you must map a folder on the host or Docker volume to the container's /data folder. This is necessary of Ubuntu containers as well as for the Alpine Linux-based Node-RED containers. If this is not done, any changes made to the container or programs installed inside the container will be gone after the container restarts. It is possible to use the -v argument to mount any folder from the host inside the container. The --- device argument can be used to pass device nodes from the host into the container. The -p argument can be used to forward traffic destined to the host to an arbitrary port inside the container. The first number is the host port. The second number is the destination port in the container. The last argument of the Docker run command is the name of the image from the Docker Hub website. The Docker Hub website has many images available. It typically also has documentation and information about the images. The Ubuntu image on Docker Hub is very lean and contains very little initially installed software. For example, if you type the command ping www.google.com, you will see there is no ping command available. If we want the ping command, we must install ipUtils-ping. We'll just hit the Y. Now that ping has been installed, I'm able to ping websites. Appendix A of our tech note includes more examples. Let's say that you want to open a second terminal into a container. We'll start a second instance of PuTTY and log into the SCADAPAK a second time with a new SSH session. After typing docker attach ubuntu, which is the name of my container, we now have a second window. Unfortunately, you will see that commands typed into one window are reflected in the other window. And even when we type the exit command, both windows exit from the container. Let's start the container again. Now if we type docker container ls, we can see that it is running. Now we can type docker attach ubuntu, and we can attach to the container since it's running. If we want a second window into the container, we have to use docker exec. This command runs arbitrary programs inside the container, and by running an instance of /bin/bash, we gain a second, completely independent terminal into the container. Now let's install a program inside the container, such as the Nano Text Editor. Ubuntu has slightly more than 50,000 packages in its App Store. Some of these packages are for other package managers, such as the PIP package manager for Python libraries, or the NPM package manager for JavaScript libraries. In the second window, we'll exit from the container and go back to the host. I'm going to start Nano in the container, and in the other window logged into the host system, we'll use the top command to list the CPU use of all processes. After scrolling down a few pages, you will see Nano appearing in the list. Even though Nano is running in the container, it is visible from the host. This is one of the large differences between containers and virtual machines. Similarly, the containers do not have an independent kernel or service manager, but instead are dependent on the ones available on the host system. The SCADAPAK 47xi Docker application note explains Docker files. Provided you have an internet connection, you can run them directly on your SCADAPAK to build containers. In this video, we gave a brief introduction to Docker, and we explained how to use Docker and build containers on SCADAPAKs that have internet access. In the next video, we will discuss more advanced topics, such as how to use the SDK to prepare Docker containers for SCADAPAKs that do not have internet. To learn more about the SCADAPAK 470xi remote smart RTU and controller with integrated edge platform, access the user documentation on the Schneider Electric Exchange shop and Schneider Electric's website. Also, see our videos on YouTube.